All right, so today on Repairs 101, I'm going to talk about the basic things that you need to know about your chainsaw.
If you're going to keep it inside, you're going to want to keep it in a container with a tight-fitting lid to contain the smell. Assembly's a snap if you've held on to all the parts. The main thing I see people doing wrong is putting the chain on backwards. So once you have that figured out, slip the chain over the sprocket as you hang the bar. I'm often asked how snug to torque the bar mounting hardware. Because there's no torque value given in the owner's manual, all I can say is tight. Beware not to over-tighten. Remember to grease the roller tip periodically. You'll need one of these grease guns to do that. To add tension to the chain, the bar is pushed out by this dowel anchored in one of these holes in the bar. Turn the adjusting screw and tighten the chain until you can only pull out about 3 to 5 chain links. Tipping the saw forward when torquing the mounting nuts ensures that the bar will be pointed up. Of course, the best thing is a brand new chain straight out of the box, but otherwise, you can put your saw in your vise so that the chain will run freely, and then have a go at putting an edge on it with a rat tail file. Of course, there's always power tools, but all you really need is a flat file and a rat tail file. Use the markings on your file guide to ensure you're getting the right angle. If you don't have a file handle, you can make one up in a jiffy, just so you don't jab yourself with your file. Measure a raker's clearance using a straight edge from the tip of one tooth to the tip of the next tooth on the same side. The rakers provide a height or clearance for the chain's teeth, as well as pushing debris from the saw's kerf. Mix fuel for your saw according to the manufacturer's specifications. If you run too lean a mixture or straight gas, you will wear down the exhaust port side of the piston and the combustion chamber. The motor will run, but it won't make enough compression to do any work, so when you go to cut something, it will just stall. Remember to fill up with chain oil every time you gas up your saw. Wear any and all the protective equipment you can get your hands on. Especially protective eyewear. Only carry a saw in your right hand with the bar behind you. Of course, this is how you should start your chainsaw, but if you're going to yo-yo start it, there is a right way and a wrong way to do that. Bucking is when the tip of the saw contacts something firm and the saw jumps back. If you're holding on with two hands, then the chain brake will engage and you'll be fine. I see a lot of people trying to use their saw like this in a back and forth sawing motion. The grabs are there to dig into the wood and pivot the saw across and through the cut. You know, I take safety very seriously, so inside my hard hat, you'll find I have duct taped a compression bandage for immediate access.